everybody. I am Miriam Pico. Welcome to the fourth week of Picnic at the Opera. I am here with the beautiful Jamie Kramer from WTCM. And playing along with us, we have pianist David Chown.
We've got some great guests for you this week here at the City Opera House. We also want to give a big thank you to the City Opera House for working with Up North TV Channel 189 to host this amazing event. Make sure you support the City Opera House for all of their great programs that they bring to Northern Michigan.
All right. City Opera House, woo!
I like the clapping.
We have got a great lineup for you this week. We have singer-songwriter and founder of the Earthworks Collaborative, Seth Bernard is here. Woo! Woo! So excited. Plus, we have local comedian Jeremy West. And the MASH-UP rock and roll musical group will perform a number from their new parody called The Sound of Uzis.
They're all dressed crazy in the backstage area. It's amazing. And then joining us later, Anne-Marie Uman, with another life lesson from stories from her childhood. We also have TC Sings Chorus here. Woo! Yeah, all right. And finally, this week, the Dance Center brings us a musical theater number. Right now, I'm going to step out of the way, and you can enjoy the sounds of Miriam Pico and David Chown.
All right. Thank you, Jamie.
It's been so long since I got to see your smile, friend. It's been so since I got to hear your voice. Too much time has passed since we shared a moment last, and now I'm on my way to see your face today. Oh,
Thank you so much. All right, everybody, come on over to this side of the stage. We have Mr. Seth Bernard in the house. Put your hands together.
Hello, thank you.
All right, for those of you who don't know about Seth, will you tell us a little bit about yourself, where you're from?
Yeah, well, I'm a Northern Michigan boy, proud father, and founder of the Earthwork Music Collective. So I write songs, play music, do a lot of community work, collaborating with farmers and schools and wonderful nonprofits here in Traverse City, and I love the fact that I'm a Michigander for life.
Awesome. All right. Seth, can you tell us a little bit about the Earthwork Collective and the performers that you work with?
Yeah, so the Earthwork Music Collective is a group of about 30 or so musicians, mostly based in Michigan. Some of us have traveled and settled outside of Michigan, Nashville, New Orleans, places like that. But we're songsters, and we love music, and we also love to use music to raise community awareness and to advocate for causes. So a lot of what binds us together is a love of Michigan and really a belief in music having the power to change the world and using music to do work for the common good locally here in Michigan.
Yes, give it up for that. That's fantastic. Love the work you do. What musical project are you working on these days?
I have a few projects going on, Miriam. I'm working with Seeds right now, a wonderful Traverse City-based nonprofit, doing a project called The Quest again, where we have musicians going into schools, elementary and middle schools across the region, collaboratively writing songs with kids, and that's a project that culminates in the summer and the kids get to perform the songs that they wrote. This year it's called Find Your Park, so the kids are exploring local parks in their areas, allowing themselves to be inspired by the natural beauty, and then writing songs about their heritage and their home place. I'm also working with Chris Treeter as the director of the Musical Ambassador Program at On the Ground. And that's a program where we collaborate with musicians in different parts of the world, Congo, Ethiopia, Chiapas, Palestine. And we work in solidarity with folks that grow coffee or make olive oil that we use here, people who are a part of our community but live very far away. And we use the universal language of music to collaborate and make new sounds together.
I love it. Well, one more time, guys, please welcome Seth Bernard. Let him know what song you're going to do. Great.
Thank you
so
much.
All right, take it away.
I'm so glad to be here. I'm going to play you guys a song by Dave Taylor, who doesn't perform or record, so I'm honored to be able to carry a few of his songs with me. This one's called World Is On Your Side.
Cup is raised, your toast is made. Another day passes you by again. With your cup of coffee, there's barely an exception to the point of which direction you can go. Need to tie your shoelace. World is on your side. World is on your side. Take your time and find your kind. Shuffle through the ropes this time you will. If you come to figure out what this whole gig is all about, tell me, 'cause I can keep a secret. World is on your side. World is on your side. Thank you. If you come to figure out this whole gig is all about, tell me, 'cause I can keep a secret. I can keep a secret. I can keep a secret. World is on your side. 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 World is on your side.
Woo-hoo. Very nice. With a healthy dose of irony, comedian Jeremy West will serve up some laughs, and this week some beautiful moves from the Dance Center. You are watching Picnic at the Opera on Up North TV, channel 189.
Up North TV channel 189 is your source for Northern Michigan television.
I'm a Traverse City native, born and raised.
As 20-somethings, wanting to be proud of the state we live in.
Events, information, and entertainment from your community is just one click away.
I was the 2010-2011 National Cherry Queen.
Fudgies. Can't drive around them, can't live without them.
Watch online or at home, Up North TV channel 189 and upnorthmedia.org. Government TV 191, Northern Michigan's source for local government. Watch meetings from the city of Traverse City, Elmwood, East Bay, and Garfield Townships, as well as Grand Traverse County. Go to upnorthmedia.org to see the latest meeting schedule. Watch online or browse through meetings with Meeting Review. Start watching your government today.
Left my home in New York City and traveled down to New Orleans.
And if you're bad at being right, learn to love being wrong. This year's a pile where we all sing.
Hey everybody, how y'all doing today? A little about me, my name's Jeremy West. I grew up in Cedar. I've been married almost 6 years and I'm not a big fan of cold weather. Now that we got that all out of the way, I can't thank you guys enough for coming out today in this crazy blizzard, right? Last year about this time, my wife and I were making plans to escape. We're gonna go to the Dominican, right? Before we went, we got a lot of really bad advice about what we should do before we go, you know? One in particular that I remember, I was at a bar drinking and this guy's like, oh, you're going to the Dominican? You know what you should do? You should get yourself a man thong. I was like, why? And he's like, well, just think about it. Nobody knows you. You don't know anybody. It's the perfect time. You can get a tan on your butt. I was like, let me explain something to you, sir. You understand that this is indicative of just all the rest of this. So if I go into the Dominican wearing a thong, you're gonna see headlines in the paper that are like Celtic werewolf loose in the tropics. And I can't have that on my conscience. I'm a little worried about geopolitics these days. I don't wanna get into anything too crazy, but I did see a video that scared me just a little. There was four Americans, right? And there was a dog trapped in the ice. So these four American dudes hopped in a boat, pushed this boat along and got to the dog and rescued it. And I was like, good. Big dog fan, it's a good day. Next video loads up. It's a Russian guy, same scenario, right? But there's a dog stuck in the ice. No boat, this guy is in a Speedo, Hulk smashing his way through the ice to get to the dog. I just think, those aren't the people we wanna go to war with for any reason, right? Like, you know, Americans, there's a guy trapped in the ice, like, hey, we need a boat, you guys. Let's get a boat so none of the rest of us fall in. A Russian guy's like, forget boat, I get dog. You know, so I worry about that. Not too much, though. I'm a big fan of music, but nothing really modern.
Is that fair to say? You guys like Bob Dylan? Yeah? All right. We're not going to get along at all. I'm just kidding. I'm a huge fan of Frank Sinatra. That's one of my all-time favorites. But I learned recently that Bob Dylan wants to do a cover of, or a tribute to Frank Sinatra, which worries me. Because, you know, Frank Sinatra's very smooth crooner type. Bob Dylan's very much not that. You know, I imagine there was a meeting where the record label was like, hey, Bob, how do you figure you're going to do these Frank Sinatra covers? And he's like, I do it my way. Oh, boy. You know, you think of a song like Come Fly With Me, right? You got Frank Sinatra who's so smooth. Come fly with me, let's fly, let's sail away. Cut to Bob Dylan. Because if you could use some exotic booze, there's a bar at Old Bombay. You guys have been a lot of fun. My name's Jeremy. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen. All right. So you may be wondering who the sisters are next to me. I'm going to introduce you to Leslie Ty and Nick Viax.
Oh, sorry, my dear. We're actually Sister Mary Harry Callahan and Sister Mary John McLean. We are from the future.
Your sister Harry?
Yes.
Okay. That makes sense. Okay, so you are two characters from The Sound of Uzis, and it's by Mashup Rock and Roll Musical. Now, okay, so this show is a spoof on The Sound of Music?
Yes, basically, in the future, after every possible disaster, humankind has just barely survived until they came. The zombies.
The not zombies.
Yes, the not zombies. They're hungry for power and world domination. And we are the only thing that can save humankind. And we have one fierce warrior named
Maria.
And when she finds out about the Von Trapp family and that they're behind not zombie lines, she goes to try and save them and teach them how to survive.
Well, considering the Pope we have today, I mean, I think this all makes sense.
Was that a dig at our Pope?
No, I love the Pope.
Oh, good, yes. It does all make sense.
Yes, we've been highly trained.
In not zombie killing? Okay, got it. Okay, so when is this... This is a show, right? When is this show going on, and where can people see it?
Yes, it is at the Inside Out Gallery, March 31st, April 1st, and 2nd. And you can go to mashuprockandrollmusical.com to get tickets.
Excellent. And both of you will be there, is that correct?
Yes.
If the apocalypse doesn't take us first, yes, we'll be there.
All right, and do you have any online presence, Facebook page or website?
Yes, we have our Facebook page, Mashup Rock and Roll Musical, and our website, mashuprockandrollmusical.com.
All right, well, I'm going to let you set this next act up because I, after speaking to you two, have no idea what to expect. Yes.
So can I go ahead and bring out the rest of our people?
Oh, go ahead. Make my day.
All right, so we have Kate Cosentino as Liesl, the eldest daughter. We have Kelly Curtis as Baroness Elsa von Schredder. We have Ben Eaton as Rolf Gruber, the messenger. We have Liam Curtis as Friedrich von Trapp. We have Tanya Ahrens as Aunt Maxine. Of course, we're going to need our musical accompanist, musical director, Tony Barrow. And of course, we have Melissa May as...
Maria.
All right. Well, I'm not a not zombie, so enjoy them.
She's finally gonna sing a song for us.
No. Now here's the drill. We're gonna start this morning with weapons basics, then move on to strength training in the afternoon, and do some hand-to-hand combat in the afternoon. Now, the first thing to remember when it comes to zombies is aim for the head. Imagine, right in front of you, a disgusting, flesh-rotting, brain-eating zombie. What are you gonna do? All right, okay. If it's the only way to get through to you, if you promise you'll learn it, no more acting like a baby, no more questions, and no more attitude, I'll sing it to you in a song.
Yay!
Ooh, hooray!
Something's wrong with the world today. I don't know what it is. Something's wrong with our eyes. Seeing things in a different way. God knows it ain't his. It sure ain't no surprise. Living on the edge.
Living on the edge.
Yeah, it's the only option you've got. You can jump off and die, or you can hang on and fight.
But Dad says there's always lots of options.
Yeah, Teddy says that when the Lord opens, closes the door, he opens a window.
Well, that might be true, but it's our job to shut the window, barricade it, and be ready with a really big gun on the other side.
Awesome. Thank you, guys. All right. Yeah, give it up one more time. Come on. Now's one of my favorite parts of this picnic at the opera show, when I get to sing with the musical guests. So, Seth, why don't you let everybody know what song we're going to do?
This one's called Tend Your Mind. It goes out to all the kiddos out there.
All right.
Start where you are. Mind your tendings. Bend but root down. End in
and begin again. Round, round, round. Smart how you are. Remember your dreamings. Big time all around. And then begin again. Round, round, round. Smile in a jar. Mirrors need publishing. Bullies always going down.
Gentlemen, I'm Jamie Kramer here with Jill Tremonti. She is the studio manager, associate instructor. She does Fresh Fusion competitions, pageant coach, blah, 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 blah. The list goes on for the Dance Center. Hi, Jill, how are you?
I'm good. How are you doing today?
I'm doing well. So we kind of like to come on before we have one of the Dance Center students do a little dance for us. And we're going to talk a little bit about the Dance Center because it has been in our community for a really long time. Jill, how long has the Dance Center been here?
We are in our 48th season right now. So we've been in Northern Michigan since 1968.
That is something to clap about, people. Absolutely. And she curtsies. It's so cute. Okay, so the Dance Center has been around for a long time. I am a former student, not a successful one, but a former student nonetheless. And you have several former students at this point after 48 years, I'm assuming.
Oh my gosh, so many.
So many. So I was really interested in, because, you know, school is always a stepping point for different things in young people's lives. And what has the Dance Center, or I should say, where has the Dance Center taken some of your alumni?
Well, we have had a lot of alumni go on to dance in professional ballet companies in particular. We've always had a really strong ballet program, so lots of ballerinas out there. We've also had people go on to dance at Disney World and Disneyland. We've had people go on to dance in commercial settings, so dancing in like music videos, dancing in musical theater. But the other thing that we have is, so people like you who have danced but aren't dancing in their adult life, the great thing about dance is that it's just like any other organized activity, any sport, football, basketball, baseball, you know, National Honor Society, all those things. It gives the kids soft skills to grow up and be successful adults. So how do you work hard on something? How do you set goals? you know, what are you, you're always working towards a specific thing. And that's why, you know, dance has been great for me, obviously, because I get to do it in my professional life, not only teaching, but running the studio. But it's also great, you know, I see myself almost as a coach too, helping those kids learn those things.
And you've brought a very special young lady with you today who's going to perform for all of you. Could you please set up your dancer?
Of course. This is Thea Gray. She's going to be performing her solo. It's called Daddy. It's a musical theater dance. It's sung by Kristen Chenoweth. It was choreographed by Holly Provenzano. Enjoy.
Enjoy, ladies and gentlemen.
Bite. He's a musician and a sculptor all in one. See how Tom Kaufman is bringing music to everyone in some amazing ways.
These are actually an outgrowth of my music programs that I started doing about 20 years ago now. Tinker Tunes, that whole music program that I was doing I started in Logan's Landing and I was doing kids' music programs, and that evolved into the instrument petting zoo and all of the musical sculptures that I've been doing ever since. All that is actually an outgrowth of all that program, but this was actually kind of an outgrowth of that program as well.
I've been a musician all my life, and the sculpting part of it, the artistic end of it, of building musical instruments, didn't happen until I started my kids' music program. And I became a huge advocate in promoting early childhood music education when my kids were small. I developed my musical instrument petting zoo, and out of that I started building instruments. I started making instruments out of different things, just to add some examples of different things that they could do at home. You know, parents that didn't have any money could build an instrument out of 2x4s, and it doesn't take any special talent to cut a 2x4 to length to tune it up. And 2x4s will actually sound really, really good. It's amazing, just a simple 2x4 scrap lumber. I see the world through my ears. And so I hear things that that I think have potential to be made into sound and into instruments. So, that's just kind of the way my brain works. But I'm auditory, and so sound is really important to me, and the way I learn, and the way I think, I guess.
Author of the new memoir, Love, Sex, and 4-H. And I'm joined by Jeanette Mason, actor and director extraordinaire from Old Town Playhouse. In this excerpt from Love, Sex, and 4-H, 15-year-old Anne Marie has been invited on her first date, and the only thing you need to know is that my mother loves to sew. For Valentine's Day, first date, 1966, my mother is at the kitchen counter drinking coffee when I tell her.
Who asked you?
Earl Bannock.
To a dance?
The Christmas dance, Mom. He's in the drama club and he's captain of the football team.
I don't care if he's captain of the Lord of Angels of the Lord. You know the rules.
Mom, you know his dad. He's Dr. Bannock's son.
Dr. Bannock's son?
She takes a sip of coffee and stares at our barnyards through the windows. Being invited to a dance by a doctor's son means something to her. This boy from a very good family, a respected family in town, a doctor's son, has invited her daughter, a farm girl. How this is handled says something about our position as a family, but it's clear this is a date.
You know father's rules.
As if I didn't know, she recites version one.
Thou shalt not date at all, not ever.
Then version two.
You are forbidden to attend school dances or date until you are older. Much older. 18, maybe.
After several hissy fits on my part, version three.
When you're 16, you can attend dances.
That's a year away. I know her one weakness. Mom, there's this dress I was thinking about. It's from a new Butterick pattern.
You don't need a new dress because you can't go.
The dress, Mom, it's kind of hard, but it's so pretty.
You heard me.
I might need some help. It calls for lace sleeves.
Lace? You don't have money for fancy fabric.
Well, I could babysit.
This is going no further.
Mom, this dress is A-lined with long bell sleeves, and if you could just help me with the zipper in back. I've never been good with those long zippers, and you always get them to lay down so they're invisible. The need to make this zipper invisible so it wouldn't be noticed wouldn't suggest the possibility of being unzipped? Ruthless.
You just have to press and pin everything first. You always skip that. You're in such a hurry.
Aha. Uh-huh. She is imagining how to do the zipper. Mom, what will he think if I tell him no? All right. What will his parents think?
I'll talk to your father.
Breakthrough. But she is no dummy.
How would you get there?
He has a car.
A car? How old is this boy?
I don't know. He's got his license.
What grade is he in?
Mom, he's a senior.
There will be no lace sleeves.
We're going to do a Beatles song for you now, and we'd love for you to sing along. When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom.
words of wisdom, let it be.
When the broken-hearted people living in this world agree, there will be an answer, let it be.
Though they may be parted,
there is still a chance that they will see.
The group behind me, they also sing. They are with TC Sings, and right now I'm with Heather Kingham. Heather, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you very much for having us.
And bringing all of your close friends.
Yep, a few of my close friends here.
So TC Sings, what is the premise? So you're open to everyone. So, I mean, if we wanted to, we could have all of you come and join us on stage right now, basically, right?
Absolutely. We're an all-comers community choir. We are a member of the Ubuntu Choirs Network, which is a Zulu word that means I am because you are. So it's all about celebrating our connections with one another. And we basically sing for the sense of joy and well-being that you get when you sing together in harmony with others.
You do. You're going to make me cry because every time I hear people sing together, I do. I cry. It's just a thing I do. So Heather, you have both afternoon and evening gatherings, I'd call them, because they're not really classes, right?
Mm-hmm. Not really. They're singing sessions. We get together on Wednesdays at noon, from noon to 2, and then Thursdays from 6:30 to 8:30 at the Grand Traverse Circuit. And we do a spring term and a fall term. We just finished our fall term, and we did a big sing, so we get our Wednesday group and our Thursday group together, and we had about 50 people to do our a concert for family and friends and for a charitable cause. We were raising money for a Northwest Michigan Community Action Agency this last time around. So
great organization.
Yeah, our new term is starting in March, and you are all welcome to join us. You're all invited to join us. In fact, can we do a quick little, you don't have to read music here. Here's our kind of our musical philosophy in a nutshell. Please join me here. Forget your perfect offering.
Forget your perfect offering.
Just sing a
song that you can sing.
Just sing a song that you can sing.
There is a crack in everything.
There is a crack in everything.
That's how the light gets in.
Woo! I didn't know I was going to be performing! Unfortunately, I'm going to go step in the back so you guys can see them.
You can just step to the back right over here by
okay.
Christy.
All right, I will. I actually am going to. I'm going to join you. I'm going to stand on stage and TC sings, ladies and gentlemen.
One, two, three, four. San, San, Croma, Nine, Wo, O se ke juma nine wo che che kokoma san san chroma nine wo che che kokoma O se ke juma nine wo che che kokoma wana chin 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 wana na te na te na te nine wo.
That that's a song from Ghana. It's in Fanti, so that was a little hard for Jamie to join in on. Sorry, Jamie. But it's about an orphaned hawk who's hunting because he doesn't have a mom and a dad. That's why we were kind of looking for the chinny chinnies. And we actually met a med student here from Ghana who was astounded that we knew that song and we were singing it here in Traverse City. So it was just a wonderful connection that music can make. So thank you so much for having us.
TC sings, everybody. Thank you so much. Wow. What a lovely picnic, right? So I'm going to leave you with a song from my album, Being This Being. And I do have CDs for sale out in the lobby, and you can find my music at earthworkmusic.com. This one's called Cinemaru. Cinemaru, how'd you do? Holding the bottom of a traveling shoe. I got all my fingers and all my toes. Sweet things come and sweet things go. Got the hi-ju-ka-ju singing my song. There's a hole in the sky 10 million miles long. Where the money men come try to make you sly. Hole in the sky 10 million miles wide. Got the cockroach coffee ground tracks on the floor. With the who, what, when, where, why, how. Open door to the pathways of now. Cinemaru, how'd you do? A hole in the bottom of a traveling shoe. I got all my fingers and all my toes. Sweet things come, sweet things go. I got the hi-ju-ka-ju singing my song. Hole in the sky 10 million miles long. Meteor crater sponsorship. Duct tape doctorate craftsmanship. With the who, what, when, where, why, how. Open door to the pathways of now. Now.
Thank you. Everybody, that is our show for you today. Please give yourselves a round of applause. You've been a wonderful audience. Big thanks to all the volunteers at Up North TV Channel 189 and the City Opera House who made this all possible. Make sure to show your gratitude to the City Opera House for providing such wonderful events for our community.
And of course, you can check out all of the community programming on Up North TV, well, that they have to offer at upnorthmedia.org. Next week, you'll want to tune in to downtown to see performances by Mike Davis Trio, DC West's musical department, Awesome Destruction, and of course, the Dance Center. And we'll be back for much, much more.
Thank you so much to Seth Bernard!
Comedian Jeremy West!
The sisters and everyone from the
including myself, of TC Sing.
Thank you, Pangea's Pizza, for helping to provide pizza for all the wonderful volunteers.
WTCM Radio for my job and for sponsoring.
Laytronics for the technical support.
NMC's Audio Tech Department. You guys rock.
The Dance Center's wonderful talent.
And the Rotten Cherries for infusing some funny into our lives.
Give it up one more time for our Woo! Wonderful guests today. Hey. All right, people. We have one more song for you today. But I need you to get your voices warmed up because you're going to be singing some Let It Be with us, with TC Sings, with the Sound of Uzis, with everybody, okay? Seth, take it away. Yes.
All right. When I find myself in times of trouble, here we go. When I find myself
in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me,
speaking
words of wisdom.
Come on, people,
let it be.
Woo!
still the light that shines on me. Shine until tomorrow, let it be.
City Opera House brings spectacular programming to Northern Michigan all year. Your support makes a difference in our community. Give today, cityoperahouse.org.
Words of wisdom.